Yes. Okay, so I will talk about paper together with my colleague Jan from SciSports. And our paper is called Player Chemistry Striving for a Perfect Balanced Soccer Team. Well, talking about a perfect balanced soccer team, I immediately think of Liverpool this season. They're like perfectly balanced. They have like all players that are playing together pretty well. They don't have one particular star player, but they have like a really balanced team. They won the Champions League last season. Currently, they are like leading in the Premier League with, I think, 22 points ahead of the number second. So they will probably win it this season. And well, this is like one of our reasons why we did this research. Because, well, it's not a team with the best players, but the players who make the best team that win. So we've seen in the past that chemistry between players has led to successes. For example, the Atlanta United duo, Almiron and Martinez, they won the MLS in 2018. They were like really strong together. Another example, Messi and Suarez at Barcelona. They're also like a player pair that like in the previous seasons won a lot of titles and they're really strong together. Two other examples, two more defensive players. Bonucci and Chiellini at Juventus, a really strong defensive duo, as well as Fidic and Ferdinand at Manchester United, who won like many championships in England. But currently, a lot of recruitment analysis in soccer is focused on individual players. And one example why this isn't the way to go is the transfer of Carroll and Suarez on the same date, 2011, to Liverpool. They both signed. And on that day, both strikers were really good at their previous clubs, at Newcastle United and at Ajax. But Carroll didn't really succeed at Liverpool. Well, Suarez did. He did great, and they earned a transfer to Barcelona in the end. But what was the reason? Well, one of the reasons behind this was that Suarez gelled way better with his teammates at Liverpool than Carroll. Carroll's like a tall striker. He needs crosses from the sides, but he didn't get them. Well, Suarez is more like a mobile striker who really strives when he gets like, the right passes. And Gerrard was a player who could give them those passes. Well, he didn't really fit well with Carroll. So what we wanted to look at is like how do players gel together? And using this example, we came up with three questions that like soccer practitioners could ask themselves. So a performance coach might want to ask like, well, how do players impact each other's performances? Or scout, like how would a given transfer target impact the performance of the players in the squad? Like for example, this Liverpool example, Carroll and Suarez. Could we have predicted that Carroll was not the right choice for them, but Suarez was? Last question, maybe from the player's perspective, so the other way around. Being a player, you would like to play at a club where you gel well with your players around you. You want to be at a club where you can, well, perform the way you want. So it's also for Carroll. Maybe it wasn't the best option for him to go to Liverpool, and maybe we could have told him, like, okay, well, maybe don't go there, but go somewhere else where you do get the crosses from the side to head in. To start with, with the performance coach question, how do players impact each other's performances? And we made like a general framework for this. Currently it's focused on soccer. This could also be applied to other sports, for example, basketball, ice hockey, where you have like a similar way of play. And we did it in like two different metrics. So we looked at offensive chemistry and defensive chemistry. So offensive chemistry means like how do these player pairs, so two players together, impact the chance of scoring a goal. On the other hand, defensive chemistry is like how do they decrease the chances of the opponent to score a goal, so decrease the chance of conceding a goal. And we built it on top of our VAPE framework that is like similar to EPV for basketball, which actually values each and every game state in a match. So to summarize, we have this player pair chemistry. For example, if we look at Robertson and Mané from Liverpool, we want to know how do they impact the Liverpool's chance of scoring a goal. And on the other end, we want to know like how do they impact the chance of the opponent to score a goal. Start with the first one, the offensive chemistry. What we look at is like interactions. So interactions are like phases of the game where like two players do like actions sequentially. So like for example here, we see that Robertson passes to Mané, who passes to the box, and that's the end of the interaction. So here I have an example of Messi and Suarez at Barcelona. So Messi receives the ball here on his own half. He passes it to Suarez, who then crosses it, and it doesn't result into a goal. But what we've seen here is we see that when Messi receives the ball on his own half, the game state value, using our VAPE framework, so the EPV framework, is 0.005, which actually means that in like 1,000 similar game states, we see that in 5 of those 1,000, we see that the goal results in the end of this sequence. So when we go to the next game state, so when Suarez received the ball, the game state value has increased with a bit. In the next one, the end of the cross, we see that the game state value has increased again. So if you look at this interaction from the start of Messi receiving the ball up until the cross given by Suarez, you see that there was an increase in game state value of 0.107. So this means that the interaction value was this value. And we do this not only for one interaction, but we did it for all interactions of Messi and Suarez in the season. So Messi passing both Suarez, but also the other way around. So Suarez passing to Messi and then to another teammate. And if you do this for all interactions that we see in the season, we sum them and then we normalize per minutes play. And that is how we get like the offensive chemistry value for all player pairs. So I explained to you the first one. So how do they impact the chance of scoring a goal? Well, we did something similar for conceding goals. So if we look in this example, you see that Bonucci and Chiellini are together defending here. So Chiellini has the duel there, and Bonucci retrieves the ball. So maybe we can look at okay. Look at it again. So here you see like Chiellini is having the duel, and then Bonucci is able to recover the ball there. So that's actually what we want to capture, like how do these players play together and how do they impact the performance of other players. So what we did is we looked at all matches that these players played in a certain season. For example, they play against Ibrahimovic. We calculate that the expected impact before this match starts. So this is based on performance in earlier matches by Ibrahimovic. Then we look at the actual impact. So what did he do in this match against Juventus? So for example, he reached 0.4, which is lower than expected. So then this difference is the credit that goes to Bonucci and Chiellini. So this example 0.2, there's a difference between expected and actual impact. But you don't only do this for the match against Ibrahimovic. We do it again for other matches, for example, against Lukaku at Inter, or other matches against Teco. And if we do this for the complete season, we can look at all these credits, like, and then we can calculate like the average of those and measure the defensive chemistry. So this actually tells us that, this is an example that Chiellini and Bonucci make the opponent play 0.13 lower expected impact than expected. So to come back to this slide, I showed you how we can how we measured like the offensive chemistry and the defensive chemistry. And I showed you some examples from high profile clubs, leagues, but we didn't only do this for these clubs, we did it for over 350 seasons across around 100 countries. You can all find them on our GitHub page, the top 5 player pairs for the defensive and offensive chemistry. And these are examples, so it goes from men's leagues to women's leagues, so Women's World Cup and WSL here in the States, but also like youth competitions like the Under-21 Championship in 2017, and also it goes back in time to 2015-2016. But it's cool that we can measure this. But it's even cooler if we can like predict this. So we know that, okay, Suarez, Messi is a really good pair, but what we actually want to know, like, how will another player that we haven't seen play together before, how can we measure how they will play when they play together? So that's what we also did. So Messi and Suarez play really good together, but while currently Suarez is injured. So we might be looking for like a replacement for Suarez. Barcelona is looking for a replacement. So we want to know like how would this replacement play together with Messi? Would he make him better? And the other way around. So what we did, we trained a machine learning model that uses our data set of 97,000 player pairs that we've seen in the past, and also their chemistries that we calculated. And then we show these player pairs as a mathematical representation that capture like the most relevant characteristics of these player pairs. And I'll show how that's done. This is a selection of the features that we used. So if you look at Messi and Suarez, we know their age, the position line, the language that they speak, country of birth, region, and also their player role, so what type of player they are, what kind of role they have on the field. And then we combine these two features of the both players to like a more like a player pair feature factor, where we say like, okay, do they speak the same language, yes or no, Do they come from the same country? Do they come from the same region of the world? So like from the Americas or not? And also how many matches did they already play together before? So if you want to predict for the current season, we know how many matches they already played up until the start of this season. And then we have the observed chemistry, which I already explained how we calculated this. That's the label that we try to predict in unseen cases. Another example, this is the worst couple current in the current Premier League season. So Moura and Harry Kane from Tottenham, both forwards, different type of players. And they don't speak the same language, not from the same country, not the same region. And we see that they have like a low observed chemistry. Another example, Sadio Mane and Andrew Robertson, who are like the highest chemistry in the current Premier League season. We see that, Robertson is like a wing back, so like more like an offensive back, who really wants to run forward, whereas Mane is also an inside forward, so he makes space for Robertson to come there. And that's what we see more often in other cases as well, but they have like really high chemistry and they don't speak the same language and stuff. So what we then did, we have all these player pairs, we have their chemistries, we have the mathematical representation of these pairs, and then we put this into a machine learning model that tries to capture like, okay, what makes this difference? Why do these player pairs have like high chemistry? Why do the other player pairs don't have the high chemistry? What we, for example, saw is that like matches played together before is like pretty high indicator of higher chemistry or not. But also like the player type is pretty important as well as whether they are from the same region. And well, I actually expected the language to play a role, but in the end, it didn't really play a big role in the model. So we use this model to predict the chemistry for three possible replacements for Suarez. So Alexis Sanchez, Martinez, and Firmino. And we construct these mathematical representations for these player pairs. So for example, we see that Sanchez, he already played at Barcelona, so he already had like a high 118 matches together with Messi before. He speaks Spanish as well, but he's not from the same country. Martinez is from Argentina, so the same nationality. They did play for matches together at Argentinian national team. And we also see that Martinez is like another type of player than Alexis Sanchez. And then Firmino, he doesn't speak the same language. He's not from the same country, but he is from the same region. So also from the Americas. But he didn't play together with Messi before. So what we then did, we took these representations, we put them in our player pair chemistry predictor, and then we get a number from this machine learning model. And I did this for these three players, as well as for Suarez himself. Obviously he is the highest chemistry with Messi, but when we look at the three possible replacements, Lautaro Martinez is the one with the highest predicted chemistry with Messi. So the one that's also from Argentina. And what we furthermore see is that Firmino is the one with the lowest chemistry currently. But that's currently because he never played with Messi before. And as I already explained to you, we've seen that players that play more together, their chemistry tends to increase. So what we did is we simulated these three players to play more matches with Messi. So we started increasing the number of matches played together. So you see this figure on the x-axis. So the more number of matches they play together, for Sanchez, the chemistry doesn't decrease, so the purple line, because they already played like 100 something matches, so they won't increase. But we see that it will increase for Firmino and Martinez. An interesting thing is that Firmino has a higher chemistry with highest predicted chemistry with Messi after around 20 matches. So if there would be in doubt about which of those two players to buy and you want to look into the future, maybe it's then better to get Firmino than Sanchez. So to get back to the three questions, I now showed you how we can do this from a scout's perspective. Also interesting to look from a player's perspective, because you want to go to a club where you end up in like a good team that fits your playing style and you have a high chemistry with your teammates. So looked into Serginho Dest, so American new talent, playing at Ajax currently, right back, and he's been, Bayern Munich has been there's rumors that they bid on him to buy him to go there. What we did, we identified five clubs that are looking for a right back and are like in the level of Dest. So Arsenal, Chelsea, Bayern Munich, Tottenham, and Borussia Dortmund. And what we then do is we put this into our team builder. So what this is like the maximum chemistry team builder is an optimization problem LP problem, where you put in all the players that are in the Bayern Munich squad. We put it in there, and then it selects the optimal lineup in terms of chemistry. So we tell the model, okay, you should select one goalkeeper, four defenders, three midfielders, and three attackers, and you should select the ones that have like the highest mutual chemistry among them. And we can use this team builder to find a good club for Dest. What we do is we have all the options in the Bayern Munich squad, so all players in the Bayern Munich squad. We add Dest to the squad. We tell the optimizer to select Dest as the right back. And then it selects all the other players that fits well with each other and also with Dest. So we optimize this for like a perspective of Bayern Munich. There it is. So we see this lineup that's optimal for Bayern Munich's perspective. Well, it should include Dest. We didn't only do this for Bayern Munich, but we did it for all these five clubs. So on the right-hand side, you can see all the optimal lineups. It might be a bit small, but they're there. And what we then did is like, we're not only interested from the perspective of the club, but we're like looking for Dest's best option. So what we did is we have all these optimal lineups from the perspective of the club, and then we look on all lines from Dest to all his teammates, and then we look at like what club of those five fits best with him from his perspective. And then, well, we end up with Bayern Munich. So this is like the optimal lineup for Bayern Munich, including Dest. And Dest has like high chemistry with, well, Gnabry, the right winger, and also with Tolisso, and also with some others. I didn't include all lines. It would be a bit many lines. But so the greater the lines, the higher the chemistry. So to conclude, I showed you our framework that measures and predicts both the defensive and offensive chemistry between any pair of players. It's a very general framework, so we now use it for soccer with the VAPE ratings. It could also be used for other sports like basketball, ice hockey, where you use like EPV metrics to like measure the value of a game state, and then also measure this the chemistry among players. We looked into the use case where we wanted to replace Luis Suarez at Barcelona, and we found out that Martinez is the best one to replace him right now, and Firmino would be like for the future also a good option. And then the last one, we showed how we can use this framework from like a player's perspective to find the best club from his for him. So that's it. Don't forget to look at our GitHub to find all the results for all other leagues like women's, men's, and so on. And well, thank you for your attention, and don't forget to vote on your favorite paper.
You spoke earlier about Chiellini and Bonucci's, how their impact on Zlatan Ibrahimovic. How did you determine that their impact on Ibrahimovic's performance was solely between Bonucci and Chiellini?
Okay, yeah, so the thing is we have event data, so we know we can measure like the impact of a player. So we have this ratings that we can measure the contribution of every player in a match. So we know for Ibrahimovic that he's a pretty good player. He always reaches like a certain level. So we have like an expectation of his performance in a game. And then we observe the actual performance. And the thing is, if you do this for one match, it will be random. In soccer, it will be pretty random. But if you do this for like a complete season, like all matches in a season, then you can find patterns. You can see that the Bonucci and Chiellini in general make their players play worse. And other player pairs do better do worse than that than they do. Yeah, that's yeah.
So, how far of your predictions have you found out? You make a prediction that a particular player goes to play for a certain club. Have you got any evidence that your predictions are working out?
Yeah, so what we do in this setting is we took the data from all these observations that we have. We select part of it. So we assume that we are in 2018, for example. Actually, 2018 is what we did. And then we predicted for the next season. So we predicted for 2018-2019 what happened. And then we compared our predictions to the actual numbers. And then we trained our model to make like, the best predictions for these left out set. So actually, that's what we did. So we do compare it to the observed chemistry, and then we predicted it, and then we could say like, okay, this is like the best model that we have, and then we can predict for the future. So like in a machine learning setting, you always have like a training, validation, and a test set. You train on something, you validate it on something else, and then you can show results for the test set. That's what we did here as well.
So you're independent, you're not tied to any soccer club?
No, well, we're a company, so we're, our clients are soccer clubs that are looking for new players for their teams. So, and our clients are like, well, clubs among Europe and away. And they're always looking for new players, but currently like it's really focused on individual players. And with this addition, we can also help them to find like the best player in terms of chemistry. Because clubs have different strategies, different playing style, different players. So a player that might be good for Barcelona might not be good for Real Madrid. And that's actually what we're trying to capture. Yeah. So I'm not tied to any club now. So the results are all independent. Yeah.
So who do Liverpool
make? We look at the Son from the Tottenham as a replacement for Mané. That's what we looked into as well. Yeah, but they're currently they already have like a really good balance in their team. So I think in the current team they don't need to change much. Yeah.
Any other questions? So you identified a set of features that helped you predict what two players, you know, how well two players may gel together. Mm-hmm. What other features can you imagine including in that? I mean, whether a player is left or right-footed, where they tend to play sort of spatially on the field. Are you planning to explore more in that area?
So what features could we add to the model or what are on the model already?
What additional features could you
imagine? So I think so left and right footed is not in there yet. I think because we didn't have the information across, but that would be really interesting. Something else I think might be interesting, but it's gonna be like long term, is more like a mental aspect. So in the end, we want to make this like bigger to go to two. Now it's like pairs, but go to threes, fours. So maybe in like a defensive line, so four defenders, you need like one more like leader type. One more like, so that's like features I think that would be really interesting to add to this model, yeah. So if you have like two players who both want to be the star player, that won't work out. And if you have two players that don't want to be, then it also won't work out, so.
Hi. You touched upon this a little bit when you were doing the last example where you had an individual player that you put into a team and saw the expected, we'll say, chemistry synergy, for lack of a better word, but for the perspective of the player. And through the example that you used throughout the paper, you used it as an example of pairs, but obviously if you think about a team, it's usually 23 plus players. So yeah. I'm thinking as the permutations and combinations go up. Does your solution, how do you think it would scale if you wanted to see like the overall expected boost of chemistry of a player being added from a team's perspective? So maybe seeing how Serginho Dest would mm-hmm. increase the chemistry of Bayern Munich overall. How do you, if you could comment on that would be really interesting.
Good question. So currently we looked at like the overall, so the average chemistry among all player pairs in the team. So that's like, what is it? Big number. At Eric B, so in the end you want to like have a squad, like 23 players that among the season would play well together. Also if like one player would be left out, would be injured, how can you replace this player? But I think in the end we want to like increase this model to going to more. So like don't do only pairs, but like trees. So now if we look at trees, we now look at all the three pairs that you have among these trees. But it might be that there's some bias in that as well. So yeah, so that's something we really want to look into. Yeah, you're right. It might scale go large if you look at to 23 players. Is
that here? Hi, thank you. You talked a little bit about the chemistry from the standpoint of other players' attributes and how they play together, that kind of thing. I wanted to see if you had looked into different systems and how that affects the players coming in, as well as coaching and how their chemistry might be different with different coaching styles or different coaches, and how that would change from team to team or in the same team.
Yeah, good point. So it's always hard, like in soccer and well, sports analytics in general, you don't know really know what the coaches tell their players. So it's always hard, and also with formations. So we didn't really look into formations yet. I think this would be also really interesting to find out chemistry among coaches and players. So what would be the right coach for your team, or the other way for player, what would be the right coach for me? That's not something we looked into yet, but it might be really interesting. It's also a thing about how much data you have available about coaches. So we don't know it always, who's the coach. Yeah.
All right, we have time for one last question. All right, then I guess the presentation was just very conclusive. Thank you very much. Please give it up for Lotte. And we'll be back in 45 minutes. Thank you.